Yesterday, there was a very big announcement that Mike Tyson is going to have exhibition, 8 rounds, no headgear, small gloves with Roy Jones. Everywhere I've been today, whether I got gas or whether I rented a car, everyone's talking about that. And it's funny because normally people don't talk about boxing at that level. You know both of the guys. You know Mike Tyson. You fought in his undercards. You know Roy Jones. I think you spent time, or your dad spent time with him?
Yeah. No, I did. No, I also fought on the same card as him.
So tell me about it. How do you see the fight from your perspective? They're in their 50s. They're going no headgear, 8 rounds.
Look, it's going to be an exhibition, because it's just not going to be sanctioned by the commission, but it's going to be a fight. It's going to be a fight. If they're wearing no headgear, small gloves, it's a fight. They're just not going to sanction it, but that fight's going to be a real fight. Tyson, fuck, he's the most known fighter in the planet. You know, he's everywhere you go, anywhere you go, they know who Mike Tyson is. And he's a legend, in the heavyweight division. But Roy Jones, skills wise, is probably one of the best fighters in history. Also, when it comes to skills, speed, and everything, it's gonna be great. It's gonna be great, entertaining for us to watch. Hopefully, they don't just go in there and play around. If they are going with no headgear and small gloves, maybe they are going to fight for real, you know. Hopefully, it'd be nice to see Roy Jones' skills against Tyson's power. It'll be interesting to watch. You know, Roy Jones also won a title at heavyweight, so it's not like it's a mismatch. You know, he did fight at heavyweight at one time and became champion, so it's going to be interesting to watch.
Let me tell you something interesting that no one's brought up yet. The date they're fighting is September 12th. Normally, it's the Mexican holiday. It's traditional for a big pay-per-view fight. Do you think any boxing fight can compete with Mike Tyson, Roy Jones that night?
Well, look, I think Canelo might fight that day, and Canelo's a big name. It all depends on who Canelo fights also. If Canelo has a solid opponent in front of him, then I think that would probably be the fight that maybe does better. Because it's a fight. It's a real fight. People might not be so interested in the Tyson Roy Jones because they're calling it an exhibition. So when they call it an exhibition, it's like, oh, it's not even going to be a real fight. They're probably just going to be touching each other. Some people might think that. You know what I mean? That might hurt it because they're calling it an exhibition. But they're both great names. Roy Jones, one of the best, most talented fighters in history. Tyson, a legend in the heavyweight division, probably the most famous fighter in the planet. So it's gonna be good. I definitely want to see that.
Who are you putting your money on?
Look, I it's gonna be an exhibition, so there's not gonna be a winner. So I can't put money on. But man, right now at their age, I'd probably give the edge to Roy Jones. I think he'll outbox Tyson.
So, Robert, thanks so much for your time. Last thing, what's your message to your fans, the people who support you, to people who are there for you, people who are backing RGBA, if they're listening or watching?
Well, look, I've been getting nothing but love from friends, family, and fans all over social media and on my phone. I appreciate everybody, worried about me. Brandon Rios called me almost crying, I swear to God, Ellie. Bro, what's wrong? Are you okay, bro? Because I didn't answer the phone call. I was at the gym today. I was at the gym, so I didn't answer his phone call. And then when I'm driving back home, yeah, he calls me again, and I answer. He's like, bro, are you okay, bro? Are you sure everything's good? He was really worried.
He's
a
real friend.
That's the type of, calls I'm getting. Donald Leary called me the same, same thing, And I'm getting so many calls, text messages from family, friends. It's just unbelievable. People are really showing me nothing but love.
No, and the best part is, look, you've done, 20 tests, 19 of them negative, one positive, but the next day, not even 24 hours later, you're negative again.
Yes.
So there is a lot of cases that I've read where tests are wrong, where they haven't been accurate. So maybe it's the case in this one. But thank you, everybody that are worried for you.
Well, look, I don't want to take it as it was a false test, one of those things that's not accurate. Because I also need to, you know, I also needed this to be extra careful in the gym. You know, now I'm bringing somebody to test once a week. They're going to be testing all my fighters and my coaches once a week. I have somebody that, Alex, who's at the, you've seen him there. He's there cleaning everything. He's making sure everything stays
sanitized.
Everybody
has masks on. Everybody sanitized.
Yeah, everybody has masks on. Now I'm going to be testing my fighters once a week. I already hired a nurse to come in every week to test my fighters. So I think that helps too. That it actually was a wake up call for us. Even though we were already very careful, I think this is going to make us extra careful.
I agree. Well, thank you so much, Robert. Enjoy your weekend. Go watch the fights. Did they start yet?
Yeah, they're about to start. So okay. I'm running upstairs to watch it. All right.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.
You got it.